I'm guessing if you're watching this video, it's because you're finding that your audio seems out of sync with your video. Am I right? And it's coming across like one of those voiceover dubbed videos. And that's not cool. So let's fix it in this video. Now in the preferences in Ecamm, you can actually add a mic delay, which is a really cool feature. So click down here to come into your preferences and we can come across to audio and right in the middle here, mic delay. And it says delay the microphone audio by this many frames. Now, typically the reason this will mess up is if you're bringing in a video from a camera like I'm doing across a HDMI input and your audio is coming in separately from a USB device, probably something like this. And you just find that when you're putting them together or you're on your live and you've watched it back afterwards, or worse still, maybe people on the live are saying, you seem out of sync. Well, this is the way to fix it. Now I've got mine set on here and as you can see, I am using this mic delay. I think it's fantastic. But how do you know what delay, what setting to put on here? That's what we're gonna sort in this video. I wanna just walk through with you the way that I would do this and set it up. So I'm gonna come back to my main window here. And I'm going to record only. See the bottom option there in destination is record only. And this is what I want you to do is exactly the same as this. Hit record on there. You'll see that it's going at the top. And then bring your preferences up. And by default, this will be set to zero. And what I want you to do is just nice and clearly talk to the camera and say, this is my recording with mic delay turned off. Then slide it across to one and go, this is my recording with the mic delay set to one. This is my recording with the mic delay set to two. This is my recording with the mic delay set to three. You get the idea. And I would take that up potentially to about eight. I don't think you're going to need to go more than eight. And again, this is the recording with it set to eight. I've seen people kind of take it from here and go, oh, well, I've put it up there, but now it's out of sync even worse. Well, it will be. Have a little play with it from zero to eight, clearly just saying something, pausing in between, and then we're going to come back and say finish, end recording. And before you hit OK, click show file, finder will pop up and it'll be in here. And if you just simply hit the space bar at this point, hit record on there, you'll see that it's going at the top. And then bring your preferences up. And what I want you to do is just to watch through that video and have a listen to it. Make sure you're doing it. Don't be doing this through any Bluetooth speakers or anything where there could be a delay anyway. Ideally, a good set of headphones, have a listen plugged in, just really kind of check it out and go, okay, where do I think it is? Now I've found that two frames is exactly what I need on here to give me that, sort that delay out. Run it through a couple of times, ask somebody, maybe post it in a Facebook group if you've got a group, post it in ours if you want to, and just give us a few seconds going, which of these do you think seems most in sync? Sometimes it's not obvious, and I think when you're looking at yourself as well, it's not particularly easy. So do get some eyes on it, but that is how we do that. We're looking up here at this red symbol at the top. When I turn this on, notice it goes up and there's a little tick saying mic delay. When I click on it, I can actually go in and adjust it from here. But as long as that is in the corner there, I know that I've got mic delay turned on. And yeah, that is how we do it. Really good setting. If you're using the virtual camera and sending this feed out to Zoom or somewhere else, the delay that you've sorted in here isn't going to get picked up in Zoom. But there is a way to do that, and we've covered it in this video up here. We do everything around here, don't we? Head over there if that's an issue to you. But if you're just looking at doing live streaming out to, or even you're just your record only in here to be recording these videos or live streaming to Facebook, LinkedIn, YouTube, wherever else you might be sending this, this is the way to do it. Well, I hope you found that useful. If you have, please give us a thumbs up. If you've still got problems, let us know in the comments and we'll try and answer it. If you haven't already seen, we've got a full playlist of Ecamm videos. Go check them out. I look forward to seeing you in one of those other videos. See ya.